Behind all these closed doors live some of the most famous people from stage and screen from the last 40 years.
See you on the other side, you goddamn cracker ass.
Jack Nicholson. Joe Pesci. Jimmy Hill.
It is a good atmosphere here.
Dirk Bogart. Al Pacino.
We go from spooky to lovely and back to spooky.
And the Rolling Stones.
Here, there's quite a demand for trellising around these parts, you know.
Where the fuck's trellising?
Roger Moore.
Now look, I've just taken a couple of Nembutal.
I can't get over this street, you know, start living in a lot.
Remember, Beverly Hills was hell.
Now, come on, Mr. Pesci. You've got to be very careful.
Hi there, Joe. How you doing? It's one hell of a hat you got there, boy.
Yeah, it's doctor's orders. And, Jack, would you mind if I asked you not to swear?
Come on, Mr. Pesci. Come on.
He got knotted up. He was sectioned. Yeah. So they dragged him off to the old funny farm.
Old Joe was digging rockeries and helping kids across the road.
Very sad. Very, very sad.
Once you go in, be very careful, it's a bit uneven.
Yeah, I'm a good boy, though.
Oh, that's right enough. You're a great little lad.
I'm a good boy.
You're a good boy. Oh, look, there's a note in the door. Oh. What's it say? Dear Joe, gone back to Miami. Take care, your loving mama and Billy.
I'm a good boy.
You're a very good boy.
I'm a good boy.
You're also very sick.
And it's coming up to a very nice consistency. You can see it there. It's a little bit gelatinous, but it is thinning out. And see, what else do I need here? It says this is the butter. Oh, unless it's actually a couple of eggs, done that. And there's a... Ah, cake nozzle. Oh, dear. I actually don't think I've got a cake nozzle.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what is to say at the end of the day? Oh.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, I'll be right here. Okay.
Alan. Felicitations of the season.
Oh.
You weren't thinking of leaving us for Christmas, were you, Alan?
Well, no. That's why I got a cab sitting out there, you know, for 3 days, so that the day after Boxing Day, you know, I got a bill for £300, you know. I mean, that's my Christmas present to myself, you know, bankruptcy.
Yes, that's quite right. No, in fact, there is a reason for my visit, Al. You know, it wasn't just a random call, shall we say. The fact of the matter is, and getting straight to the point without, you know, beating around the bush, you know, and I always think it is good to get straight to the point. I'm not one of these sort of people who goes off at tangents that really don't, you know, get to the point, because that really can annoy people, I know. Because the fact of the matter is, I have a cake.
Oh, you got a cake. You know, that's real thrilling, you know, I'm really thrilled, you know. Tell me more.
Yeah, yeah, but what, you know, what you could say, really, for this cake to be a viable, working cake, I'm going to need a little layer of marzipan across the top, and for that I'm going to need a catering appliance or nozzle, and that sadly I do not have.
Well, okay, well, there is £50, okay? Do yourself a favour. Get yourself down a shop, and find yourself the biggest marzipan, ding dong, jingle bell, Santa Claus, shit cake fuck you can lay your fucking hands on.
No, Al, you know, surely, very nice and all that, it being Christmas, thank
you
very
it's
much,
almost
it
a fucking
is appreciated, but I'm going to have to give that back to you because, you know, surely the lads down at the store there who've been working hard to serve the public all season, surely they deserve a break.
Yeah, and so do I.
Joe? Ah. Hello, Joe.
Hi, Mike. A lovely day, isn't it? You know, everything in the garden is beautiful.
So, how are you, Joe?
Oh, I'm tickety-boo. You know, it's like what Alistair Cook said this morning on that wonderful, thought-provoking program, Letter from America.
So, what did old Cookie say then?
Well, he said the world is like the wide-open spaces.
Yeah?
What?
Wide-open spaces, Alistair Cook.
Never mind. Oh, look at the time. I gotta get myself down to church hall. You know, there's a woman's whist night tonight. You know, I gotta make all the tea, big teapot, you know, and lay out all the tables and chairs. And I gotta cut the sandwiches, you know, and the lady sandwiches. You know, they gotta be very triangular, very finicky, very feminine.
Joe, you, have really changed.
Well, I got a new hat.
Oh, my God.
Let's get it straight. You want me to go back indoors? You want me to go back upstairs?
Well, Al, it was a moment of pure speculation on my part.
Okay. Try and speculate on this. I got a cab sitting out there that's probably run up about 60 pounds, shillings, and shit, or whatever you call that fucking maple money you got over here, okay? That translates into Queen's English as, I'm fucking out of here.
Bye, Al.
What do you want, Roger, a fucking egg whisk?
I just wanted to wish you a Merry Christmas.
It's no one's business what kind of fucking Christmas I have. It's strictly personal.
Oh, I have the dubious honor of driving the Godfather to New York. I assume you're going to New York, Al. Probably to do the Godfather Christmas special.
Dean, I'm off to Chippinghambra. Or maybe Melton Mowbray. Or maybe Tyne on the Avon. Now, burn rubber. And I'm in now!
Why can't you just stack the macaroni straight like I told you?
I stack it straight enough. People are going to come in and they're going to fucking take it. What's the fucking point about worrying if it's all niggly up in a fucking pile?
People aren't going to want it if it looks...
Fuck, it's always the fucking same with you, man. You know that?
Oh, everything you say is just stupid and you've got no talent
either. After your ass got too big, man, it was me they listened to.
You know that's not true. Everything you say is just stupid.
I'm gonna fucking kill you, Jigger.
No.
Fucking kill
me. Oh, no. Oh, no. Put it away, Keith. Put that gun away. Help somebody.
You know, Mick, I'm the only person who'd ever shoot you. You know that? You know that? And the only reason I haven't is because you keep hopping around like a piece of popcorn.
Oh, no. Don't. He's gone mad.
Pop the suet pudding and to hell the Marifat fucking feed.
Help!
Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Hey, I thought you guys was friends. You know, and friends is what we need. It's like what Stephen Fry says in that beautiful film by Kenneth Branagh. You know, Peter's friends. He says that, we're all kind of thrown down a chimney together. And then we're sort of thrown together for life.
Joe, you're doing this for a bet.
Bet? Oh! No. No, I haven't betted since the mists came down.
You won't pull no muffin with all this Hawaiian wallpaper wrapped round your foul gut.
Listen, Mrs. Hugget, while I'm soaking up the rays in paradise, you're gonna be checking into Sadsville in Leicestershire, Barrow, with that goddamn nagging hag of a daughter of yours, huh? Chew on that. Come on, Jackie's sorry.
It's not you, Jack. It's my daughter, Maureen. Well, she wrote to me and she said that she didn't want my fat, burpy old arsehole over her nice new sofa.
Oh, Christ, come on. Look, Mrs. Huggy, come on, sweetie, come on. You don't need her.
No, you don't fucking need her.
Come on.
No, she's a bleeding cow, Jack. How come so afraid of spending Christmas alone, you know?
Here's what I'm gonna do. That's right. There. Now, look, here we go. Here's $1,000, Mrs. Huggett. Why don't you take a vacation somewhere warm, huh?
Jack, you're an angel of mercy, Jack, you know.
You gotta look after yourself.
You're an angel of mercy. You've got a lucky face.
You bet your ass, girl, huh?
Yeah.
Now, you have a good time and be good to yourself.
You understand
what I'm saying?
I will.
You hear me, don't you?
I do.
All right, now listen, I gotta go off and do some more packing, so if you could just, you know, carry on. Thanks very much.
God bless you, Jack.
Don't even mention it, Mrs. Hugget.
All the things a girl's got to do to get some poppy from these tight-ass movie bastards.
Cuckoo.